There's a big dragon around your neck, the little girl told him. It's big and green and covered with blood. He wondered how she could see it. He couldn't even see it. Hadn't seen it for years. But the grip never loosened, not an inch, not in 6.5 decades. He wore his shameful noose, strangled by it every day, boozed and slept with it night after night. It doesn't like you, the little girl told him. It's big and mad and won't stop staring at you. He wondered how she could see it. He couldn't even remember the last time he'd seen it. But its big dragon cock was down his throat, and its dragon knife tail sawed his back and raped his ass. And her claws ripped at him, every moment with a violent, invisible fury, even strolling along the beach. Nothing says family, he told her quietly, toweling his hands. Like a drug addict and a child molester, as she floated in the bathtub, skull down. And it was November. Again.